Zallow and Malgus closed. They halted at 1 meter, studied each other for a moment. A human male Jedi Knight separated from the swirl of battle and stabbed at Malgus. Malgus sidestepped the blue line of the blade, punched the man in the stomach, doubling him over, and raised his own blade for a killing blow. Zallow bounded forward and intercepted the downstroke. Zallow and Malgus stared into each other's faces, and the rest of the battle fell away. There was only Malgus and his rage, and Zallow and his calm. Their blades sizzling in opposition. Each used the force to press against the strength of the other. But neither had an obvious advantage. Malgus shouted rage into Zallow's face. Only a furrowed brow and the tight line of his mouth betrayed the tension behind Zallow's otherwise tranquil expression. Feeding off the anger from Alina, Malgus shoved Zallow away and unleashed an onslaught of overhand slashes and crosscuts. Zallow backed off, parrying, unable to respond with blows of his own. Malgus tried to split Zallow's head, but Zallow blocked again and again. Malgus spun into a high, force-augmented kick that hit Zallow in the chest and sent him flying backward 10 meters. Zallow flipped and landed upright in a crouch near two of Malgus's Sith warriors. They lunged for him, and Zallow parried one blow, leapt over the second, and spun a rapid circle, cutting down both Sith. Malgus, burning with hate, flung his lightsaber at Zallow. He guided its trajectory with the Force, and it spun a sizzling path through the air at Zallow's neck. But Zallow, riding the momentum of his attack on the second Sith, leapt into the air and over the blade. While Zallow was still in the air, Malgus unleashed a blast of energy that caught the Jedi unprepared and sent him crashing downward into a pile of rubble. He lay there, prone. Malgus did not hesitate. He mounted the column of his anger, shouting with hate, and leapt 20 meters into the air toward Zallow. Mid-jump, he used the Force to recall his blade to his hand, took a reverse two-handed grip, and prepared to pin Zallow to the temple floor. But Zallow rolled out of the way at the last moment, and Malgus's blade sank to the hilt in the stone of the temple's floor. Zallow leapt up and over Malgus, landing in a crouch, reactivated his lightsaber, and pelted across the floor back at Malgus. Eschewing speed and grace for power, Zallow loosed a flurry of rapid strikes, slashes, and lunges. Malgus parried one blow after another, but could not find an opening to mount his own counterattack. Lunging forward, Zallow slashed crosswise. Malgus parried, and Zallow slammed the hilt of his saber into the side of Malgus's jaw. A tooth dislodged, and his respirator was knocked askew. Malgus tasted blood, but he was too deep in the Force for the blow to do real damage. He staggered backward a step, as if the blow had stunned him. Seeing an opening, Zallow stepped forward and crosscut for Malgus's throat. As Malgus knew he would do. Malgus turned his blade vertical to parry the blow and spun out of the blade lock. Reversing his lightsaber during the spin, he rode it into a stab that pierced Zallow's abdomen and came out the other side. Zallow's expression fell. He hung there, impaled by the red line. He held Malgus's eyes, and Malgus saw the flames of the burning temple reflected in Zallow's green irises.
"It's all going to burn,"
Malgus said. Zallow's brow furrowed, perhaps with pain, perhaps with despair. Either way, Malgus enjoyed it. He waited for the light to disappear from Zallow's eyes before jerking his blade free and allowing the body to fall to the floor.